It's not always fun being an imaginary friend. I mean, my existence depends on the whim of a 7-year-old girl. Beautiful 7-year-old girl. I'm here because she needs me here. I'm gone just as fast. Asking what it's like to be an imaginary friend is like asking what it's like being a human. I can't really say. It's just an existence. I don't know any other. I've gotten used to it, though. To getting sat on, having doors slammed in your face, being denied on a regular basis because Lucy, the girl I'm imaginary friend to, is embarrassed of me. But I'm devoted to her. Without her, I couldn't laugh or cry or think or anything. I can't help it if I'm imaginary. I just like some recognition, that's all. Like the other day, before dinner, Lucy blamed me for eating all the cookies.
These are so good.
Lucy! I told you you couldn't have any cookies before dinner. Look at you, you're a total mess.
Well, you see, Paul ate all the cookies. And then he said, hey, Lucy, let's juggle them. So we were juggling, and he missed. And then it got all over my face. I'm sorry, Mama, but I didn't eat any of the cookies, I promise.
Excuse me? I did what? That's not fair. I'm sick of getting blamed for the stuff you do.
I never do something like this to you.
But, Paul, no one can see you.
Excuse me?
Nothing, Mama.
All right. Well, tell Paul that he was a very bad boy and that he made me angry.
Yes, Mama. He knows.
Let's get you cleaned up. Come on.
I'm sorry, Paul. She just blamed me, and I couldn't do anything about it. No one cared. No one knew they should care. There are other downsides to being an imaginary friend, outside blame.
Sorry, Paul. May I sit down now?
Yes, Mama.
So, how was practice?
Good.
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 Sometimes I have to wait till the very end of a meal to get any food. Sometimes I just scrounge around for myself when everyone's asleep. I guess what you're really asking is if I'm real. I sometimes wonder that myself. I think, therefore, I am. It's a very shallow concept when put into my position. I guess I am because I am. It's as close to my understanding as I can get. Sometimes it's not that bad, though. Me and Lucy have a lot of fun.
Lucy, stop it. You're making a mess.
Oh.
Lucy tells me all of her secrets. She tells me what she's afraid of, and that I'm the only person who knows. She tells me I'm the most important person to her, and the person she cares about the most. She tells me she loves me. She told me she was afraid of the dark and asked me if I'd protect her. I said always, always. She doesn't love me though. I figured this out soon enough.
Come on, let's go play.
Hey Lucy, tell me about your imaginary friend.
You have an imaginary friend? That's so lame.
I know, Lucy. You just have to get some real ones for once.
Hey, Lucy, tell me about your imaginary friend.
You have an imaginary friend?
What's the matter? Don't you have any real friends?
She does, too. I'm a real friend. You tell him, Lucy. I love you, Lucy. Remember? Always. I don't have an imaginary friend! I don't have an imaginary friend! It's not true! I never did! I'm not a baby, I'm not! I don't have an imaginary friend! People with imaginary friends are crazy!
But Lucy, you know that's not true. I'm right here.
It always ends somehow. You can't ever grow up. One day, they're too big for you, or you're too small for them. Just like that, you're on a trip, never returning, dead. Some horrible accident. You never existed. All I ever wanted was to be noticed.